we had a patient who was very, very ill. His PSA was 2,500, which is exceptionally high. And then on the imaging studies, he had big, bulky tumors in his liver. And that's kind of unusual in prostate cancer, and it portends a poor prognosis, really. But he joined our clinical trial, and after 3 weeks, so after one dose of the immunotherapy, his PSA went down to one. So it was 2,500 and then down to one. And then it just kept going down, and he was initially treated in early 2016. And if you look at his chart these days, his PSA is still 0.0. My name is Julie Graff. I'm a medical oncologist, and I'm primarily based at the Portland VA healthcare system, but I also work at Oregon Health and Science University. In the prostate cancer world, I'm focused on immunotherapy at this point, so getting the immune system amped up and better able to fight prostate cancer. So immune therapy is very different than chemotherapy, hormonal therapy, and I'm interested in it because when people's cancers respond to it, they respond wonderfully and for a long time. Cancer can look like to your immune system that is just part of you. You know, I'm just part of Paul, I'm just part of Julie. In reality, it's a tumor that grew out of one of your cells and may look a little bit like you, but it's not supposed to be there. And so we call that evading the immune response. So you're getting away with being there, you're sending away the immune cells. And one way to overcome that is by blocking the negative signaling that might be coming from the tumor. I'm very fortunate to work with these patients, and I don't look at patients like a person with cancer inside of him. I think about the whole guy, and prostate cancer patients tend to live for a long time, months to years, and we get to form a very special relationship. And often we use humor together, and you know, they show me pictures of their grandkids, and one of them invited me to a 70th birthday party, and I've been to birthday parties. I just really, really enjoy these guys, and always in the back of my mind, I'm thinking, how do I kill the cancer? Sure. But more, how do I help this guy live better? And sometimes I can't cure the cancer, so maybe I can help with pain, maybe I can help with depression, maybe I can just be there for him.